Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the last part, or the last regular part at least, we finished off level 5, so it's about time to move on to level 6. Now the entrances to level 6 are up here, and clearly they are a one-way street. If you drop down here, there's no way back up, except if maybe you use a mantle in combination with a flying boots item or something like that. But obviously that's going to be pretty expensive just to get back up here. So if you're ready to go down, make sure you really are ready and don't go down here before these portals are open, because there is no way out. Okay, so there are two different entrances, so you might think you have to choose carefully which one you take, but that is not the case, because clearly they both end up in the same room. Here's the second obstacle for getting back into level 5. So once you go down here, there is no way back up. Except if you maybe lure a monster up here or something, which is possible, but it takes forever, so yeah. Just make sure you want to get into level 6 before you go here. Now there's two ways to go from here. You can either go to the right, which is clearly a shut off little area that doesn't lead anywhere. Or you can go to the left, which leads to these two tunnels and the food shop. Now unfortunately, both of these are in fact a dead end. You can either go up top here, which just leads down a very very long corridor, which ends up here. So on the tunnel you can see on the top right here, that's where this tunnel leads. So that's kind of useless. This one leads to a little teleporting area, but it just leads you to a different dead end, so there is no way to get into the further level through here. So you might wonder, like, okay, so how am I supposed to get in? Because there appears to be no way in. Well, there's, as far as I can tell, the only possible way of getting into this level is by using a Madoc. You can either use it here to get on this side, or you can use one here to get into this side. Or, of course, you could use one here, but if you use it here, or even here, there is no way to get back up, so I prefer using one of the other ones, because they are relatively easy to reach. My personal preference is this one, just because it's a little bit easier to reach to get back up here if you need to, although in practice you don't really need to get back up here too often. So let's just get our way in sorted, and there we go. And as you can see, we can just walk back up here now. Now you're already seeing some of the monsters in level 6 running around here. You can see they look quite scary. In fact, they are quite scary. They are pretty strong, but thankfully not that much stronger than in the previous level, so you have to be a little bit careful. Bloodworms happen to be one of the more powerful creatures in this level, so be a little bit careful of those, but most of them are pretty similar in strength to the level 5 guys. And if I am not mistaken, I don't think there are any, or at least not many, creatures here. Ooh, as you can see, 20,000 in a single hit, so yeah, they are pretty tough. There aren't too many that use a lot of powerful magics either, so yeah, this is... Compared to level 5, the difficulty level isn't that much higher. Now the first bloodworm, I happen to know, drops a candle, so I'm just gonna kill him and not waste my hit points on it. Let me show you a couple more spawns of the bloodworm, because the second one actually does start moving, so you have to be a little bit more careful. On the other hand, it is a gold dropper, so it's definitely worth chasing after. There. 800 gold apiece, it's not the most you've ever had, but it's, of course, very nice to have anyway, damn it. You have to be a little bit more careful than I am. I just blew up 1600 gold, which normally might be cause for restarting, but yeah, whatever. The third spawn is still a very powerful one. It's a static one again. But this one we do want to try and get with our regular weapon, mostly because they drop a nice item. Again, close to 20,000 damage for a single hit, so yeah, be careful. But of course a Madoc is worth it. Then the final spawn. Now this is the one I was talking about. This one is actually very weak. So the first three spawns are tough to deal with. The fourth one is very aggressive, as you can see, but they have extremely low strength, so they can't really hurt you. Unless you're still at your level 2 armor or something, but yeah, by this time you're not going to be there anymore. So the Bloodworms, the last one, is just a really easy easy kill. Now the other kind of worm, which is the one you saw crawling around down here, is also pretty strong, but nowhere near as strong as the Bloodworm. They are more in line with the level 5 style strengths. The first and the second spawn are food spawns, so you don't have to waste your hit points killing them, but just use your magic instead. But if you wanted to get some fighter experience, these are definitely some of the guys you could attack with your regular weapon. Or of course the power up your armor a little bit, because yeah, ours is still a little bit lower than our plate, than our half plate was, but we're pretty close to getting it to becoming more powerful than we were before the upgrade. I think our defense was 6600 with our half plate, and we're up to 64 now, so yeah, we're getting good. Let me get a couple more hits from this guy just to 65. Still 65. Still 65. Okay, well, whatever. Although clearly this is not good for our hit points. Yeah. But we have so much gold now, it's pretty easy to just get healed and or even pick up some more red potions or something, you know. Now these guys are... I feel they have... I don't remember, either a key or a pendant. One of them has a key, one of them has a pendant, so this is one or the other. Oops. Did a little bit less damage there, but that's a coincidence. I think all the Necrophidiuses are similar in strength, so... yeah. This was the key one, so there's one more that drops a pendant. Oops, ow. Okay, I didn't mean to do that, but I lost focus for a second. Let's just use the red potion, so we don't die instantly to the next hit. I have to figure out where the shops are on this level, I'm not sure yet. I think they probably are behind some sort of a locked door or something like that, but I guess we'll find out. Okay, so this gives you kind of an impression of what kind of monsters we will run into in this level. Oh shoot, I should have attacked him with my halberd. Lost a pendant there. Oh well, not that big a deal. Yeah, so on this level, hey, I think I... oh wait, of course, yeah, no. I thought I went through another teleport, but no, there's just a normal dead end down there. Under all this yellow and blue brick, I think is our main tower for this level. But the little tower is, I believe, at the bottom of this pit here. Or around here somewhere anyway. This level has two towers, a small one and a pretty large one. The small one is the one I want to show you guys first, of course, because obviously it doesn't have the ending boss. Oops, no. I guess it wasn't down here anyway. Yeah, after all, I guess it's down that other tunnel down there. I think we can get there through here. Or did that lead to the same place? Oh yeah, this is the exit from the main tower. Owlbear is also pretty scary. Pretty tough, if I'm not mistaken. Pretty strong. Checking my notes for a second. Owlbears. Yeah, these are, yeah, I think these are the strongest creatures on level six. So you have to be a little bit careful. On the other hand, oh, lucky. Sometimes you'll get your hit in before they do, and of course that's always lucky. But they do drop red potions, so usually it's worth taking a little bit of damage from them, because the red potion will generally heal more than you lose from these guys. Okay, so this wasn't the way to go, obviously. Oh, I remember now. You have to get past the other bloodworm and fall down the hole on that side. Oops, damn it. So clumsy. Wasting so much gold by killing these boxes. Never a good thing. I normally don't play this badly. It's just probably talking and thinking about other stuff while fighting is... yeah, that's my excuse anyway, and I'm sticking with it. So yeah, this is kind of like a ladder, only a little bit more annoying. Oh yeah, just move diagonally. I mean, that's probably pretty obvious, right? So if you move diagonally up to the left and the top, you can skip over this thing. But I'm sure you figured it out by now. Checking my time real quick, see if I'm not overdue. Okay, getting there. So this is the way to go down here. Yeah, I think I'll show you how to get to the tower, and I'll do the actual tower in the next part. So you drop down that hole over there. You can go this way, but I think that just takes you down to an area where you can't really get out. I'm not sure. But the way to get to the tower is through here. So what you have to do, this is one of these jump tricks I was talking about earlier. It's a little bit annoying, but it's not one of the... it's relatively simple, I think. What you do is you jump onto this thing first. Then you jump up until you get to the two spaces. And then when you're next to the second stalactite, whatever it is, you move to the right. So 1, 2, 3, here we go. And make sure you don't move any further than you, because you'll fall off, of course. Then for the second jump, you start the same thing I was doing before, only you start moving to the right again when you're in the air one space. If you do too early, you'll just fall down this hole. Which is very likely to happen now, but I'll try and show you the proper way to do it. 1, 2, here we go. There we go. This one looks tricky, but it's actually pretty simple. To jump over the first one, you just press up and right, and just keep it pressed, and I'll show you what happens. There you go. Because the first jump is always a single jump, the second one is always a single jump, but the third one is always a double jump. So yeah, it looks like it might be tricky, but it's actually pretty simple. And that takes us to... Oh, that actually takes us to the big tower, I remember now, yeah. Okay, so that's not where we want to go quite yet. I'm pretty sure we could probably take it already, but I want to... I always want to do all the side stuff first before I end up doing the major stuff in a level. Don't remember what this is. Oh, Madoc, okay. That's nice. Can never have too many Madocs. So let's first quickly go back up here. Hopefully I'll have time to showcase the entry to the final tower, if I can just hurry up a little bit. Getting very close to our 15 minute mark, so... Run, little Xanadu, run. So you do have to drop down here, but instead of going the route I just showed you, you actually do have to go down this ladder, I believe. Oh, this is where the shops are, so that's good to know as well. But yeah, you have to get all the way to the bottom, and from there it should be pretty easy. Yep, this is it. So you get all the way to the bottom first. Let this monster pass for now. And this is where the other small tower is. Okay guys, we're getting dangerously close to the time limit, so I'll see you in the next part.